So we have seen the introduction to part 1 and we have a glimpse of what we are going to learn in part 1 of physics class 11. Now let us see what is there in part 2. So in part 2 we have this chapter 9. Chapter 9 is mainly concerned about mechanical properties of solid. So what are the mechanical properties of the solids? Suppose if we put some force, how will this solid behave? So introduction to this mechanical properties, elastic behavior of solid. What is elastic behavior? Stress and strain. Stress means when we put something in force, and strain means when this thing is either compressed or elongated. So it will either show elastic behavior or it will show compressive behavior. Those kind of things in stress and strain that we will see later in detail. Hooke's law, what is Hooke's law? Stress and strain curve, this is quite important curve to understand different type of materials, that how does steel behave and how does other type of material like rubber will behave under force. So this is very, very important from the perspective of an engineer. Elastic moduli, so this we will see, an application of elastic behavior of materials. So what are the applications of these behavior? So this we will learn in chapter 9. Now let us see chapter 10. So till now we were seeing the mechanical properties of only solids, but in chapter 10 we will see the what are the mechanical properties of the fluids. So first introduction to the chapter, then pressure, how does fluids behave under pressure, types of flow, streamline flow and different type of flow, turbulent flow. A very important result for fluids is Bernoulli's principle, that we will learn in this chapter. Viscosity, that means fluid friction. Viscosity is something like fluid friction, you know about friction, but there is friction also in different layers of fluid, that is called viscosity. And at last, surface tension and many more things which are not written here, that we will learn in this chapter. Chapter is mechanical properties of fluids. After that, chapter 11, thermal properties. Till now we have some idea what is heat and how does it flow, but in this chapter we will learn in much more advanced way, in much more in detail, what is heat and how does it goes from one end to another end in the different type of material. So introduction to the topic, thermal properties, temperature and heat, what is temperature and what is heat, measurement of temperature, how do we measure temperature, ideal gas equation and absolute temperature, what are these, thermal expansion. So absolute temperature is temperature in Kelvin, but why do we use this K, Kelvin temperature. So that we will learn in this chapter. Thermal expansion, so if we heat something, that will expand, but why do the things expand on heating? So that we will learn. Specific heat capacity, so how much amount something can take when it is heated. Calorimetry, measuring these things. Change of state, so you have already seen ice is melted into water and water is converted into vapor. So that we will learn, why does this happen. Heat transfer, so what is the phenomena behind heat transfer, why does heat transfer from one place to another place. And at last, Newton's law of cooling, if we keep the things, hot things for some time, it will cool. Why do things cool? So that we will learn in this Newton's law of cooling. After that, chapter 12. So chapter 12 is thermodynamics. So previously we have seen that something heat transfer was happening, things were cooling or things were heating, but why they are doing so, there must be some reason, that's why they are doing something like that. Those fundamental things we will learn in this chapter 12, that why it is happening so, that things are cooling or things are heating up. So thermodynamics, so first introduction to thermodynamics, what is thermodynamics, what is thermal equilibrium, that means a balance condition, zeroth law of thermodynamics, heat, internal energy and work, what is heat, what is internal energy and what is work in terms of thermodynamics, that we will learn. First law of thermodynamics, so we have three laws of thermodynamics, zeroth, first and second law. So first law of thermodynamics, again specific heat capacity in terms of thermodynamics, what is specific heat capacity. So these things plus thermodynamic state variables and equation of state. What are the variables on which this thermodynamic system depends? Thermodynamic processes, what are the processes? Heat engines, that means whatever the engines you use in car or bus or all those kind of engines are heat engines. How does a heat engine work? That we will learn in this chapter. Refrigerator and heat pumps. Refrigerator is also a heat pump, both are same. How does a refrigerator work? That we will also learn in this chapter. Second law of thermodynamics. Previously we have seen zeroth law, first law. Here we will see second law of thermodynamics. Reversible and irreversible processes. This we will see something later. And at last, Carnot engine. Carnot engine is a very important topic. This we will see in this chapter. Now, kinetic theory. So, what is kinetic theory? So, we know gases keep on moving in a room. So, these move in a random fashion. That's why we feel gases are there in the room. Or we have learned something about that diffusion process. But why does that diffusion process happen? So, this we will learn in this kinetic theory of gases. Here it is simply written kinetic theory, but it is kinetic theory of gases. We will learn about gases only. So, first introduction to the topic kinetic theory. Molecular nature of matter. So, how matter or every material is made of molecules. Behavior of gases. Kinetic theory of an ideal gas. For ideal gas, how does this kinetic theory work? Law of equipartition of energy, that the energy is divided equally with every degree of freedom, that we will learn later. Specific heat capacity and mean free path. These are very different kind of topic and we will have to spend some time to understand these topics completely. Now chapter 14 and 15. These chapters are very different from the whole second book. All the other chapters were dealing with the properties, but here we are dealing with waves. All others were dealing with the matter, but here we are not dealing with the matter but waves. So first, oscillation. So you know what is oscillation. Suppose if you have a simple pendulum, you put it like that. If you take it on one side and leave it, so it will try to oscillate like this. So it will keep on oscillating. So these are called oscillations. So chapter 14 is about oscillations. First, introduction to oscillations. What are oscillations? Then periodic and oscillatory motions. What are periodic and oscillatory motions? That we will learn. Simple harmonic motion. What is simple harmonic motion? There is a difference between simple harmonic motion and these oscillatory motions. Simple harmonic motion and uniform circular motion. So how do they compare? Now after that, velocity and acceleration in simple harmonic motion. So in the first part we have seen there is a velocity and velocity in circular motion, but what are the velocity and acceleration in a simple harmonic equation in terms of waves? Force law for simple harmonic motion. So how does this force law will work for simple harmonic motion? Energy in simple harmonic motion. Some systems executing simple harmonic motion. Damped simple harmonic motion. Damped means something is restricted. So if you leave it oscillating, after some time it will stop. So why does this pendulum stops? That we will learn in this damped harmonic motion. And last is forced oscillation and resonance. These we will cover in this chapter, oscillations. Once we learn about oscillation, we will learn about continuous oscillations. Continuous oscillations make waves. So first we will understand the introduction. What are transverse and longitudinal waves? By now you have learned that sound waves are transverse waves and light waves are longitudinal waves. Displacement, रिलेशन इन अ प्रोग्रेसिव वेव. द स्पीड ऑफ अ ट्रेवलिंग वेव हाउ डू वी कैलकुलेट? द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सुपर पोजिशन ऑफ वेव. सुपर पोजिशन मीन्स दैट मीन्स एडिशन. हाउ डू वी एड टू डिफरेंट वेव्स? रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ वेव्स. सो वी हैव सीन द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट बट हाउ डू वेव्स रिफ्लेक्ट? बीट्स. सो वॉट इज बीट्स एंड डॉपलर इफेक्ट. दिस इज द पार्ट टू ऑफ फिजिक्स क्लास 11th. So these two chapters are quite different and need a lot of attention.